When you run a quantitative UX study, you will always have at least one independent variable and at least one dependent variable. It's important to understand these foundational research concepts in order to avoid making big mistakes when designing your study. Independent variables are something you manipulate. Dependent variables are the things you measure as a result of that manipulation. Okay, so let's map out these variables in the context of an A/B test. We have two designs, one with a large button and one with a small button. In this case, button size is your independent variable. Design A and design B are two members of your independent variable. We can measure the effect of your independent variable, button size, with dependent variables. In an A/B test, a common dependent variable could be click-through rate or conversion rate. We can measure these dependent variables for design A and design B, so we can quantitatively compare results. It's okay to have multiple dependent variables to assess the effect of your independent variables, but be wary of adding additional independent variables, especially in an A/B test. For example, what if design A had different photography, layout, and button size from design B? How do I know which variable had which effect? In general, we recommend that you keep your changes small to limit the number of independent variables. Remember, the more independent variables you include, the harder it will be to garner specific insights from your study. This can all get messy and confusing quickly, which is why it's important to spend time establishing your independent and dependent variables well ahead of running your quantitative study. If you find yourself unable to limit your variables, consider a qualitative study instead, or consider taking another research approach to focus your objective. It is easy to run a study which takes time, money, effort, and tells you nothing useful. By defining the things you'll change, independent variables, and the things you'll measure, dependent variables, you can make sure to maximize the impact of your quantitative UX studies.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at this over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, ngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live hands-on UX training.